139 of the show. So if you're new here, make sure you check out our other videos. See the description below for access to the 1% Engineer Kit, where you can sign up for our newsletter, access to our Discord server with 1,400 engineers, and our Instagram page. This video is backed by data from the 2019 IEEE USA report that has looked at electrical engineering salaries for the last 33 years, and I am blown away by how high some of these salaries are for these job categories. You're going to be pleasantly surprised with some of these and overall shocked by others. You're going to see some jobs ranked as the illustrious S tier, some pretty good as A tier, and some that are okay as B tier. They're sprinkled all around and not necessarily in a particular order, so make sure you watch this video till the end. What type of electrical engineer do you want to be? I respond to 100% of comments nowadays, so leave a comment below with any type of question or any sort of concern about engineering. I will answer it. Without further ado, guys, let's get right into this video with category number one. Yep, we're starting off with the highest type of salary. I'm going to give it to you guys right up front and center, which is smartphone and watches engineers. This is the job category where the median salary, including benefits and bonuses, is $215,000. I have never in my entire life seen a salary like this that is outside of the C-suite, outside of the executive corporate ecosystem. Electrical engineers are some of the heroes within the ongoing revolution in mobile devices like smartphones and watches. While much attention has been focused on the user-facing design of smartphones and other contemporary electronics, the internal functioning of these devices is just as important to their ultimate acceptance by organizations and individuals. For instance, their CPUs, networking capabilities, and batteries dictate their look and feel. And all of these components are the work of electrical engineers. Let's take a look at all of the most recent iPhone designs, the 12, 11, and the X. One of the biggest storylines about these handsets is the distinctive notch black bar intruding into an otherwise edge-to-edge organic light-emitted diode or an OLED screen. Opinions differed on the elegance of its appearance, but its placement was ultimately determined by engineering constraints. Apple's electrical engineers had to fit many advanced electronics into that notch, including a dot projector, flood illuminator, proximity sensor, and infrared camera. These features work in tandem with the phone's front-facing camera to support the Face ID authentication system, which is an alternative to signing in with the passcode. Due to the total size of all of the different hardware required for accurately scanning someone's face, the notch reached down into the top center of the OLED display. High-profile mobile tech like the iPhone is hardly the only domain for electrical engineers working in this category, but it is the highest paying and the fastest growing. In each of these fields, electrical engineers operate largely out of the public eye to ensure the efficiency, safety, and cost-effectiveness of the numerous essential systems underpinning today's hottest technologies. Their work doesn't normally catch the public's attention, like the iPhone models, but it always makes a difference in how numerous in-demand gadgets and infrastructures actually function. Without question, electrical engineers working on smartphones and smartwatches is an S-tier avenue. Guys, if you are interested in electronics at all, this is exactly one of the directions that you should consider for your career. The next job category is energy and power engineering. I got a lot of questions about energy engineering and some about power in the mechanical engineering job tier list video that came out last week. Many engineers consider mechanical versus electrical engineering. I made a video specifically with that title, and if you're interested in seeing the job tier list for mechanical, go check out that video after you watch this one. Let's first define the differences between energy and power. Energy refers to a variety